Hello and welcome everyone. Welcome to my another video, and in this video I'm going to talk about how to crack JavaScript interviews. So I have a good experience of taking and giving the interviews, and I know what you need to prepare for the JavaScript interviews. I mean, there may be a different positions around React.js, React Native, Node.js. I mean, JavaScript is used where you are writing Angular, React, React Native, Vue.js, and you are writing the APIs in Node.js, Nest.js, or I mean all different framework you are using, right? But when it comes to a basic interview, I mean I'm talking about international and India interviews in from Indian companies, it's more about core JavaScript. Nobody deals with the real framework because it is easy to learn the framework, it is easy to understand and get hands-on and on any framework. But what we need to be strong at is the core JavaScript. If you are good at the core JavaScript, you can learn React, you can learn Angular, you can learn Vue.js or any other client-side framework, and same as server-side framework. You don't need to learn in depth about how GraphQL Apollo client-server, how Nest.js is working, how Gatsby or Next.js is working, different framework in Node.js or different client-side framework we have in JavaScript, right? What you need to be good at, the core JavaScript functions, how the basic, the core functional oriented, or you can see the JavaScript core is just the functions and prototypes and the objects. So you have to understand all those fundamentals, and you should be able to answer all these questions, okay? So the core questions which I see is about the prototypes, how the object cloning, object shadow cloning, deep cloning of object works, how the getter setters works with the classes and the object, how we can freeze an object, what all different methods the object function provide, like object.create, object.freeze, different property, object.define properties, right? How we can do a deep cloning, right? Like using object.assign or deep cloning by stringifying the object and then parsing it, or using a spread operator. That is still only copying the top level object, but can we write some code to do the deep cloning of an object? And furthermore, most of the questions talks about the prototypes. Okay, what is a function prototype? How we can copy the one function's prototype into another? How we can clone an object properties from one object to another object, so that if I change the object, that secondary object, it should not impact my primary object. So it's all about deep copying the objects. Then it comes to, talking about scopes and closures, how we manage the local scope, global scope, what are the different module types we use in JavaScript right now. We have a common JS modules, the ES6 way of importing modules, or different module loaders we have like Webpack, Browserify. We are not exposed to these because we are using Create React App, Angular CLI, Vue CLI, all these tools. So core JavaScript fundamentals talks about the different variables, right? We talk about primitives, we talk about the different types like symbol, object, functions. Because what happens, the basic questions people were not able to answer. So what I did is I just wrote this blog, and I'm talking about the very basic things about JavaScript. Sometimes people are not able to answer what is the type of capital A array, because array is a function which is having these prototype methods. Type of object is itself a function. Type of string is a function. Here these are capital A, capital object, capital S. So JavaScript is a function. Everything is a function. Even type of function is a function. How, if we go into the deep, then people might ask about the prototypes, how, why we need prototype, how the prototype is getting copied from one function to another function. When we create a constructor of a function, what actually happens, like function hello, now you are writing new hello, how this object creation internally works, right? So it's all about functional oriented programming, where we are creating the prototype of function A, inheriting those properties into function B, which now we are using as a classes, right? How we can invoke a function by itself using immediate invoking block. Module pattern in JavaScript, you might have used, we used to use a a different type of module pattern like CommonJS, ES6, or all these patterns. Then most important questions comes to async pattern in JavaScript, like dealing with a callback, dealing with async await, promises, promise chaining, running up promises parallelly, how we can deal with the callback hell, or the latest questions which are coming. They will give you a scenario and they will ask you to identify the blockage we are creating in the event loop, because we should not be blocking the event loop by writing a lot of async await loops, right? How we can run the different promises or different asynchronous event parallelly without creating any kind of race conditions. How we can now in core JavaScript, the important questions are regarding the proto and prototype. People get confused with the proto. What is proto? What is prototype? Proto is something with the object, prototype is something with the functions, and all the inheritance works based on the prototype. All the inheritance and the chaining of object works based on the proto. Like you got an object, const obj equal to empty curly braces. Now obj dot underscore underscore proto, where it will point to? It will point to the proto of a capital O object. If you do further dot underscore underscore proto, then it will point to null, because this is a proto chain we are creating, right? So you should be good at the vanilla JavaScript, and then you can pick only one framework, because learning any framework is easy. Either you pick React or either you pick Angular. You can find hundreds of JavaScript questions anywhere, like what is a type of operator, what is instance of how, what all different methods we have in the array. Most important JavaScript coding questions were asked on the JavaScript array.prototype methods. Like they will give you the questions on splice, slice, map, filter, reduce. How the immutability works with the array prototype methods, like when you do dot map, it gives you the new array. When you do dot filter, it gives you a new array. Similarly, other like for each is just iteration. It just used to iterate on an array. Similarly, we have other methods, right? So JavaScript coding questions moves around just filtering some kind of object using map filter for each methods, and some coding questions about converting the promisified code into async await or converting the callback code to the promises, right? And they can give you a sample of the code, like how to basic recursion happening in the JavaScript. And they will ask you about event loop, if they moves into the Node.js, how it works, different types in the JavaScript, how you can define the type, like type of null and type of undefined. Sometimes experienced developer is unable to answer the type of undefined and type of null, why they are different. When I do triple equals undefined, triple equals null, why this is coming as false? Because the type of undefined is undefined, but type of null is an object. So the type is not same, that's why they are coming as a false. Okay, so I have already covered a lot of interview questions in my previous playlist. This was just about to display you the top 20 questions and top 100 questions. If you're interested, if you're looking for a job as a beginner, or you switch from one stack to another stack and looking for the job in that particular stack, then it is very easy. Just go for the core fundamentals. These days JavaScript is more popular because it is diverse. It is there on the server side, it is there on the client side, and there is a huge chunk of frameworks available, and it is getting popular and popular. Okay, if you talk about the latest, then you can also explore in the coming videos. I will be talking about the latest features of JavaScript, like ES7, ES8, ES9, maybe ES10. So you can keep yourself updates on all these things. Thanks everyone. Thanks for watching. You can subscribe my channel. I will be posting more videos.